Come the spring, the Conservatives could face a bigger battle than ever in places like Hillingdon, Wandsworth and Kingston. Next April, our poll tax bills will come thudding through the letterbox. The following month, voters will have the chance to show what they think of the size of their bills in the local elections. Some Tory MPs are very much afraid that marginal Conservative councils could be lost altogether. Worse, they could see Tory marginal parliamentary seats going as well. It's a sizeable problem. In London, there are 8 councils where the Tories have a majority of 5 seats or less, and in some cases rely on the support of other parties. NOP carried out a survey a few months ago for the Local Government Chronicle. They found then that Labour was already 6% ahead in the marginal areas. 7% said they'd consider changing their vote because of the new tax, and 63% were against the community charge anyway. The government have published guidelines setting out how much they expect local authorities to charge. According to those, there'd be very little change, except, of course, that more people per household would be liable. Add to that the fact that some local councils say they don't stand a chance of sticking to the guidelines, and you see why 10 Tory MPs were worried enough to go to the Commons today to see Kenneth Baker, the Tory chairman.
If a man standing on a cliff edge going to jump himself off, both you and I would stop him doing so. We changed the widows' allowances for those pre-1973, and as a British Legion member, I'm glad we did yesterday. It is never too late in politics to bring sanity in. And we believe, as those of us went to see Mr. Baker today, that we were bringing sanity into politics and the Conservative Party right at the top.
And to them, that means scrapping the safety net in which better-off boroughs will subsidise poorer ones, and they want high-spending boroughs penalised. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.
Gym protest. Originally, 60 workers walked out in support of Mr. Kinnan and 2,000 others were laid off. But today, other members of the Transport and General Workers Union came out in support. Management say the dispute has cost them £5 million so far. They expect to meet the union tonight for talks.